Hello and welcome to St. Chad's. We have come together online but in our Father's presence to offer him through our Lord Jesus Christ praise and thanksgiving, to hear his most holy word, to pray for others as well as ourselves, and to ask forgiveness for our sins. Let us then confess our sins to Almighty God and pray together. We say together, Lord our God, in our sin we have avoided your call. Our love for you is like a morning cloud, like the dew that goes away early. Have mercy on us, deliver us from judgment, bind up our wounds and revive us, in Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. If we claim to be without sin, we deceive ourselves, and the truth is not in us. But if we confess our sins, he is faithful and just to forgive us our sins and to cleanse us from all unrighteousness.
Our first reading today is taken from Psalm 32, verses 1 to 8. Blessed is the one whose transgressions are forgiven, whose sins are covered. Blessed is the one whose sin the Lord does not count against them, and in whose spirit is no deceit. When I kept silent, my bones wasted away through my groaning all day long. For day and night your hand was heavy on me, my strength was sapped as in the heat of summer. Then I acknowledged my sin to you, and did not cover up my iniquity. I said, I will confess my transgressions to the Lord, and you forgave the guilt of my sin. Therefore, let all the faithful praise you while you may be found. Surely the rising of the mighty waters will not reach them. You are my hiding place. You will protect me from trouble and surround me with songs of deliverance. I will instruct you and teach you in the way you should go. I will counsel you with my loving eye on you. This is the word of the Lord.
Let us confess our faith with the words of the Apostles' Creed. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived of the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, died and was buried. On the third day, he rose again. He descended to the dead. On the third day, he rose again. He ascended into heaven. He is seated at the right hand of the Father, and he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting. Amen.
Good morning. Our second reading today is taken from Colossians chapter 4, verses 1 to 14. Masters, provide your slaves with what is right and fair, because you know that you also have a master in heaven. Devote yourselves to prayer, being watchful and thankful, and pray for us too, that God may open a door for our message, so that we may proclaim the mystery of Christ, for which I am in chains. Pray that I may proclaim it clearly as I should. Be wise in the way that you act towards outsiders. Make the most of every opportunity. Let your conversation be always full of grace, seasoned with salt, so that you may know how to answer everyone. Tychicus will tell you all the news about me. He is a dear brother, a faithful minister, and fellow servant in the Lord. I am sending him to you for the express purpose that you may know about our circumstances, and that he may encourage your hearts. He is coming with Onesimus, our faithful and dear brother, who is one of you. They will tell you everything that is happening here. My fellow prisoner, Aristarchus, sends you his greetings, as does Mark, the cousin of Barnabas. You have received instructions about him. If he comes to you, welcome him. Jesus, who is called Justice, also sends greetings. These are the only Jews amongst my co-workers for the kingdom of God, and they have proved a comfort for me. Epaphras, who is one of you and a servant of Jesus Christ, sends greetings. He is also and always wrestling in prayer for you, that you may stand him in the will of God, mature and fully assured. I vouch for him that he is working hard for you and for those at Laodicea and Hierapolis, our dear friend Luke, the doctor, and Demas. They also send greetings. This is the word of the Lord, and thanks be to God. Thank you.
The message today is taken from Colossians chapter 4. I wonder how devoted we are when it comes to prayer. Prayer can be hard. Sometimes we don't even know what to pray or how to pray it. But God's left his Holy Spirit to help us to pray. In verses 1 to 7 of this chapter, Paul speaks about three things that we need to do to pray right, and to pray strong, and to pray in faith. First of all, we have to devote ourselves to prayer. Prayer is to be a continual watch. We are to continue to pray. Always. Pray always. Well, that sounds a bit ridiculous in some respects, because how can we pray always? How can we pray to God on every occasion, in every way, with every thought, with every second of the day? It seems impossible. And yet prayer is much more than just saying words. It's far more than closing our eyes or putting our hands together or getting on our knees. Prayer is about a relationship with Almighty God. For prayer is not just the words that we speak, but prayer is a listening to what God has to say to us through his word and through other incidents and occasions. But the incidents and occasions, or the other things that in which we believe God is speaking to us, must fall in line with what God has said in his word. For instance, God tells us that we should not be joined together with unbelievers. He tells us that if we are, we should stay that way. But he tells us that we should not be joined together. And yet so often you hear young people saying, young Christians saying, I know he's not a Christian, or I know she's not a Christian, but I love them and I want to get married to them and I want to spend the rest of my life with them. The question is that according to God's word? Is that what God is teaching? Well, that's just one simple example. It's not meant to be the gist of this message. It's just one thing in which very simply and very easily we can fall into the trap of believing God is speaking to us when God is not actually speaking to us at all, because it's not in accordance with his word. Prayer is to be continual. We're meant to have a continued relationship with the Father, so that at any moment we can turn to the Father and ask him for our needs or for the needs of others. So prayer should be a continual watch, continually looking for opportunities or for reasons to come before the Lord and pray. My mother-in-law used to pray, Lord, give us a parking space. And the answer was, sometimes no, sometimes yes. But she would pray, and she would talk to, she would say that she talks to Jesus as if he was there in the house. She spent hours and hours in prayer, and she listened to God. And very often I heard her say, I prayed to the Lord and asked him, and there it was, there it happened. So prayer should be a continual watch. It should be part of our relationship with Almighty God. If you're married or if you have children, your relationship is built on your relationship is built on communication, isn't it? When communication breaks down and people drift far away, so does a relationship. Prayer should be made for those who share the gospel. We're told, you don't know what to pray for? Then pray for those who share the gospel. Pray for the missionary societies. Pray for the missionaries. Pray for those that preach the gospel. Pray for your church leaders. Pray for those in authority over you. Pray for the peace of Jerusalem. Pray. These are all things that are in the scripture. All things that we can pray for. All things that we need to be doing. We should be praying for those things which God tells us to pray. We should be praying according to the word of God. We should be praying for openings. Do we pray for openings? Do you get up of a morning and say, Lord, give me an opportunity to share the gospel today? I guess most of us don't. But we need to be looking for those opportunities, and those opportunities arise so often. And prayer we should pray for clear proclamation. We shouldn't worry about what we've got to say. We shouldn't worry about those things that we need to say. What we should be doing is praying that God will give us the words to speak when the opportunity arises. We need to be looking for it. And then in verse 5, there is practice. The way we live should be a reflection of our faith. We should practice our faith wisely in front of the unsaved people around us, that they may see who we are and why we do what we do. And in verse 6, we need to be wise in the way that we share our faith. But we need to share it at all times. A word in season and out of season. And Paul's friends. Well, I'm not going to go and look at Paul's friends today on this video, but we'll say something about that in church on Sunday. But we need to realise the simple rules that Paul has laid down for us. First of all, prayer. Prayer is to be continual. Prayer should be made for those who share the gospel. We need to pray for openings, and we need to pray for a clear proclamation for us and for those who speak the gospel. We need to practice what we preach. We need to live in the light of what Jesus did for us and in front of unsaved people around us, so that they see that we're different because we've trusted Jesus. And we need to speak wisely of our faith at all times and in every opportunity. Amen.
Change.
We pray the prayer that Jesus taught. So as our Saviour has taught us, let us pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, for ever and ever. Amen. And a collect for today. God of glory, touch our lips with the fire of your Holy Spirit, that we may all, with all creation, praise your holy name and rejoice in your presence through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Let us bring prayers of intercession before the Lord. Almighty God, we thank you that your written word continues to inspire us, showing us who you are, how you loved us, and how we should love you and live our lives. Thank you too for the way in which the Bible brings guidance and hope to people everywhere. We pray for the work of the Bible Society and others that translate your word and bring it to life in the light of understanding of many peoples in many nations. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Faithful God, we pray for Christians throughout the world, and particularly for those who are persecuted because of their faith. We ask for your protection for them, and strength and guidance for all individuals and organisations that seek to help them. We think, Lord, of Open Doors, of Barnabas Fund, and many others. Lord, we pray also for the whole family of your church here in Liso. May we all be renewed in your love, in our love of the scriptures, that through the study of your word, we might encounter Jesus and allow ourselves to be transformed by his words and actions. We ask for your guidance on all that we do in our church to ensure that we serve the local community in the way that you want us to. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Creator God, we thank you that the scripture shows us you care for the entire world and all of its peoples. And we pray for all countries that are torn apart by conflict, illness and hunger. We pray for peace in the world, bringing before you the troubles and dangers of people and nations. Particularly, we pray for Ukraine. Shower your blessings on communities seeking to rebuild their lives in peace and hope, guidance and protect refugees fleeing from war, hunger and persecution in their homelands, and direct all rulers, governments and leaders of people to strive for justice, peace and fair shares for all. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Gracious God, we pray for the sick, the lonely, the hurting in our community, and for those who care for them. Help them to draw near. Give them strength and love in the Lord Jesus Christ. As we think of the power of your word and that's to set captives free, we pray too for those who are chained by situations beyond their control, mind or spirit. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Holy God, thank you for hearing our prayers. We ask you to guide us with your Holy Spirit in all that we do and say in this coming week. Merciful Father, accept these prayers for the sake of your Son, our Saviour, Jesus Christ. Amen.
To sing your praises, I'm so
Let's close our service today with the words of the grace. May the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ and the love of God and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us all evermore. Amen. Now go in peace to love and to serve the Lord. In the name of Christ. Amen.